Hi, my name is Brady Feigl.
And my name is Andrew Schrock.
And this is This Week in Mount Athletics.
Drive inside, dump over to Julian from the corner. Shot,
got it, and he hit it!
Once again, I am senior left-handed pitcher Brady Feigl.
And I am senior right-handed pitcher Andrew Schrock. We have you covered from the left and the right on This Week in Mount Athletics as your host for this week.
It may be February, but spring is definitely in the air. In Major League Baseball, pitchers and catchers are set to report to spring training, and my team, the baseball team, is 9 days away from our first game against St. Louis in Florida.
We can't wait for our season to begin in a few weeks, but now let's take a look back at Mount Athletics action from last week. The indoor and track and field team competed in NEC Indoor Championships this weekend, and here's Brady with the recap.
The Mount men's team was led by freshman Kobe Rosemere Guccio, who was named the NEC Most Outstanding Rookie Performer after placing second in the 200-meter dash, fifth in the 60-meter dash, fourth in the long jump, and helped the Mount to a win in the 4x400-meter relay. Senior Gigi Gibilesco was a member of the winning relay and also finished first in the 800-meter run. Gibilesco's sophomore brother, Jamie, and senior Tom Fitzsimons also ran a leg in the 4x400-meter relay. Junior Scott Rice finished fifth in the pole vault, while Fitzsimons was seventh in the event. Junior Billy Lawrence brought home a sixth-place standing in the high jump. On the women's side, senior Jess Huber was third in the pole vault. Senior Morgan Oshjeszewski was sixth in the weight throw with an ECAC qualifying mark, while sophomore Desi Scott was seventh in the 800-meter run, and junior Tika Robinson finished seventh in the triple jump. The men finished fifth as a team, and the women were 10th. Let's now turn our attention to the hardwood. This week is rivalry week in the Northeast Conference, and the Mount has been paired with Wagner in what has been dubbed as the North-South Showdown. Here's Andrew with details on the women's game against the Seahawks.
Junior Selena Mann nearly became the second player in the Mount Division I history to register a triple-double in Mount's 71-48 win against Wagner on Saturday. Mann finished the game with a career-high 10 assists along with 10 rebounds and 7 points for her fourth career double-double. Sophomore Ashley Christie paced the Mount with 15 points, while junior Sydney Henderson posted 14 points, sophomore Jesse Kaufman added 12 points, and junior Tara Lonergan chipped in 11 points in the win. The women's basketball team has won 2 in a row and looks to compete the North-South Showdown sweep tonight against the Seahawks. Tonight, the Mount will also join the fight against breast cancer when the squad plays for K. Here is sophomore Jesse Kaufman with a message about tonight's game.
Hey, Mount fans, this is Jesse Kaufman from the women's basketball team. Do you still sense love in the air? On Wednesday night, the women's basketball team will be hosting Wagner at 7 p.m. During the game, fans that donate $3 and wear pink will be admitted to the game for free as the Mount helps the WBCA raise awareness for breast cancer in our Play for K game. We would love for you to come out to Knott Arena to show your love to the Mount women's basketball team against the Seahawks and help raise money for a great cause. We have raised over $1,400 in the first 4 years of the event, and we would love to see your support again this year. If for any reason you cannot make it to the game, you can catch all the action at www.mountathletics.tv. Go Mount!
And now let's check in with Brady on how the men's basketball team fared against Wagner this week.
Wagner took both games in the home and home week-long series. The Seahawks defeated the Mount 59-44 at Mount Arena a week ago and then down the Mount 74-57 in Staten Island on Saturday. Sophomore Julian Northfleet had a team-high 18 points while freshman Kelvin Parker chipped in 11 points in the contest in Emmitsburg. Junior Raven Barber paced the Mount with 16 points and freshman Chad Holly added 12 points in the game at Spiro Center.
I would like to congratulate track and field athlete Kobe Rosemere Guccio on being named the Mount Athlete of the Week.
As you heard earlier, Rosemere Guccio placed second in the 200-meter dash, fifth in the 60-meter dash, fourth in the long jump, and helped the Mount to a win in the 4x400-meter relay to be named the NEC Men's Most Outstanding Rookie of the Meet at the NEC Indoor Track and Field Championships.
With spring right around the corner, the Northeast Conference has been releasing the preseason polls for the spring sports.
The Mounts men's lacrosse team has been picked as the preseason favorite after winning the inaugural NEC title last season. The women's lacrosse team picked up to first two-place votes and finished third in their poll. The softball team was picked 10th and the baseball team was tabbed 6th, while the women's tennis team was picked 5th and the men's tennis team was selected 7th. The men's and women's golf preseason polls will come out on Thursday and Friday.
Top plays of the week returned last week, and I would like to congratulate Kelvin Parker's steal to Josh Castellanos' layup against St. Francis, PA, Kelly Guerrero's three-point display against Robert Morris, and Kelvin Parker's dunk against Robert Morris for being selected as the top plays for the Mount last week.
We will be back with our final top plays of the week nominees for basketball next week. We will then compile all the weekly winners and will have the fans decide what the player of the year was for both men's and women's basketball.
This season marks the 50th anniversary of the men's basketball 1961-62 national championship title. We will relive each game from this season with retrospective thoughts from legendary head coach Jim Phelan and players from that great Mount team in a series called Unraveling the Bowtie. We will unveil the final three regular season game recaps of that season this week, so make sure you look for those videos on MountAthletics.com, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.
The Mount will pay tribute to the 1961-62 national championship team at halftime of the men's basketball game against Monmouth on Saturday. Fans in attendance will receive 50th anniversary pins and 50th anniversary rally towels.
This week marks the final home games for the basketball teams. The women's basketball team kicks the week off tonight against Wagner at 7 p.m.
The men's basketball team will host Fairleigh Dickinson on Thursday at 7 p.m. Fans in attendance will receive a free rally towel. The game can be seen on Masson, Fox College Sports, and ESPN3. We know that we have the best fans in NEC, so make sure you come out and rock the knot so we can show everyone that we have the best fans in the league.
On Saturday, the women's basketball team will host Fairleigh Dickinson at 3 p.m., and the men's basketball team will conclude its home slate against Monmouth at 7 p.m. Before the women's game, senior Sandra Adjison will be honored, and prior to the men's game, senior Danny Thompson will be honored.
The women's basketball team will conclude its home schedule against Monmouth on Monday night at 7 p.m.
Women's swimming will be at the NEC Championships next week, and another sign that spring is in the air is that both the men's and women's lacrosse team will open the season next week.
We have started a Twit Pick of the Night contest at our home games, so the next time you're at the Knott Arena, tweet at Mount Athletics a picture during a game, and you could win a Mount t-shirt.
Remember that you can get all of your Mount Athletics news at MountAthletics.com and check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube by searching for Mount Athletics. You can also like us on Facebook by texting Like Mount Athletics to 32665.
Once again, I'm Brady Feigl.
And I'm Andrew Schrock.
And this is This Week in Mount Athletics.